Hey folks, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to Parkasaurus, the phenomenal little park builder. There's children screaming outside my window. I'm very sorry. Welcome back though. The game is actually updating with a brand new DLC for the first time in a couple of days. The Sea Monsters DLC comes out on the 11th of August. You can wishlist it right now on Steam. And what it does is it takes the already humongous dinosaur roster in the game, which actually gets 6 new dinosaurs, as you can see, with the update. And it adds in our prehistoric aquatic creatures as well, our sea monsters, which is a nice catchy term. I know some people will take issue with the word monster, but it's just meant to be cool. And it also adds some new campaign missions. I'm going to try one of those out today. So you will have to work through the campaign a little bit. You could, of course, just play on sandbox as well. But all the sea monsters campaign missions are right here at the end of the game. You basically have to get 18 rockets to get this far, which, you know, of course you do. And there's 3 new levels. There's Factory, which I tried. That's why it's already got 2 stars. And I don't like the level. Basically, it's because you're limited to building right at the start. I don't know if I was being stupid, but I just couldn't build anywhere, basically. And it felt very limiting, so I didn't really enjoy that. We've got Fire Party, which terrifies me because it's got an 8-day par time, which is absolutely humongous. And we've got Shipyard, and that's what we're going to try today. So it adds some really cool species to the game. It's got Leopleurodon, it's got Dunkleosteus, and it goes all the way up to things like Megalodon. So that's really exciting. We'll definitely try those out in the future. Let's try out this Shipyard mission to kick things off, though. Boop! Also adds a new tank system and heaters and all this kind of jazz. Tons of stuff, tons of stuff. Quest Shipyard. The delivery of illegal sea monsters has been caught at the seaport. Help make them a temporary home by creating below-ground water exhibits. Okay, so we've got a shipyard, we've got shipping containers, we've got ships, oddly enough. Do we have a yard, though? We've got ships, we've got a lighthouse. I don't know how any of them get out, but that's neither here nor there. Big old water tower thing. And I think this is probably our buildable area, right? Yeah, we've got a nice... Oh, very nice. Big chunky areas that we can build in. This one's a little bit limiting, but that's okay. It just means we're going to have to make a cool looking habitat. So, these are going to be below water ones. You can make above water ones now with this new heavy physics tool thing. But for today, we're just going to do the mission. So, we need to create an exhibit. I'm going to build around the shipping containers. I think that's going to look really cool. Okay, let's hope for the best. So there's a new biome brush, the ocean one. Now, how this game handles biomes is actually really, really cool. So you can see here we've got grass, for example. If I put grass everywhere, inherently it'll make a forest biome. If I then add loads of water to that forest biome, it becomes a rainforest. And if I add loads of mountains, it becomes a taiga. Same kind of deal with sand and the mud. It depends on the water and the height map. With the ocean, it depends on how deep the water is and the temperature, and that'll swap it between a beach, lagoon, or photic. It's a really, really interesting, unique little system, actually, where the biome is dependent upon the geography of your exhibit, basically. So let's cover all this in ocean sand to kick things off. There is currently a demon crawling up my throat, so if I if I disappear, that's why. To clear my throat, not because of demons eating me. Maybe because of demons eating me. Okay, so we've got our beach. We now need to use another new tool. Well, with deep water, which I think has always been there. This is new, though. This here. Not this. Smart water. And that'll basically flood... Can I show you? Let's find out. Yeah, basically, it floods the area. As you can see, it's not really working because there isn't glass wall or anything here. I need to clear my throat. My God. If I had, like, a glass tank wall, you'd then fill it up as much as you want using the smart water, which is pretty cool. But today, we need deep water. So let's get some, basically. There we go. And you can see it just became a photic habitat. So, let's get it nice and moist for the donkey. There we go. Now, I tried this a second ago and it kind of broke. And the Dunkleosteus never released, so I've not been any further than this, but let's try this again. Eh? Not working. Hey, there we go. Into the water, buddy. So what, I'll force you in there. Fantastic. Now, please expand your temporary park into a wonderful place for dinos to live. All right, cool. Can we get you into the water? There you go. Much better. You happy? Yeah, happy. Got the right size and everything. How big is the exhibit? 694, oh, it's bigger than I thought. Sweet, okay. And there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, we have Merlin and the Dunkleosteus. What an absolute hero. There he is. So you can see I'm using the realistic skins for our cartoon ones as well, if you wanted something with a bit less texture, yada yada. It's to the point where they look pretty good overall. The only thing that's like perversely cartoony is the eyes, obviously. But there is our donkey. Oh, I guess I can walk everywhere. So we need some more creatures now, right? We don't just have them by default. We need to go hunt them down, essentially. So what we're going to do, we're going to go into the portal. Can we hunt for aquatic yet? So in the portal room, we can then hunt for aquatic and semi-aquatic creatures. And I don't really have any in mind. What we should do first, if we head into town, into the egg store, you'll see we've got a bunch of them here. We've got Archelon unlocked. Pretty cool. And we've got Plesiosaurus unlocked as well, which is awesome. And we actually need a tier 2 one with the uncommon. What else have we got? We've got Leopleurodon, we've got Ichthyosaurus, we've got Atopodentatus, another big old turtle. We've got Placodus, Elasmosaurus, Mosasaurus, Megalodon, some high tier creatures there at the bottom. And Sarcosuchus as well. Oh my god, amazing. There's some really cool... Oh, can I afford that? No. Some really cool ones down there. Let's go for the Archelon though. I think Archelon sounds awesome. To kick things off. So we need to do a semi-aquatic hunt, basically. So we go to the portal and... Oh, we need to hire some staff first. So we go to our office, we go to our resumes, and we're just going to pick one of each staff member. We're going to get Gamonth, because that's an incredible name. We're going to get Bella, because she looks like an absolute chad. Scientists. I always go for like two people. Bellar. And Chromon the Prek. These people have incredible names. It has to be Chromon, obviously. So we've got one of each. And there's a few little things we kind of need to do at the start. For example, we always need a science building. I'm going to just tuck that away in the back corner for now. And what we do is we grab our little science person. Bellar. And we plop them into our science building. And they'll kind of just do a little dance, basically. Unironically, they'll stand there dancing. As you can see. I think it's meant to be they're doing science. It just looks like they're boogieing to me. They're going to do a little dance, and they're going to generate us some science points, which we can use to unlock new things. New things are cool. Okay. All our guests are coming in. Can I buy any... Yeah, we've got some decent stuff by default. So one thing we need to do right away, basically, is grab some donation boxes. You want these basically all over the place. Like so. And that'll start generating some money from people who view our Dunkleosteus. We can make this exhibit a little bit better as well. It's actually amazing as well because we have to wait for our portal. Ah, right, yes. So basically you need your staff members before you do your portal run because you see you get these markers and that's how you dig. I'll show you that in a minute, but we're looking for semi-aquatic and you can choose how deep you want to go and that determines sort of how many items you're gonna get. I tend to go for deep because if you find any money it kind of justifies it essentially. So we're gonna go for deep, nice and deep, and okay, cool. And what I kind of want to do, because at the moment this is all path, right, all of this, I don't really like that my guests can kind of just walk everywhere because they're stupid and they don't deserve that. So I'm gonna kind of delete some of this path maybe. Just want to restrict their movements a little bit more, you know? You will go where I tell you to go, you numpties. Seems I can't quite do all of it. Like, if it's underneath the things, but I can go like that, and yeah. We can kind of just make it look a little bit nicer. Actually, what I might do is just this. Actually, I might just do this. There we go, lovely. A bit more control. We're going to need a food stand. Some description. What are we feeling? I really like... Where is it? Where's it gone? Tom's wonton trunk. Because first of all, wontons are amazing. Right? That's step one. But really, there's something about a wonton trunk that just makes the people happy. What can I say? So what we need to do for that, what we'll do next, we'll have a look at our dunk. And this is quite a boring little exhibit, right? We can spice things up a little bit more. You can see if we go here to exhibit, it's only 50%. So what you need to do is add three different things, rocks, bushes, and trees that are suitable for the habitat. So you can see we've got these ones here. And the really cool thing about these, you see if I click here, you can see that the follow-up one looks different. They rotate, they resize, they re-angle, stuff like that. Don't actually need any more, but they look cool, so I'm gonna throw some in anyway. So basically, just as you're dashing them around, you'll get like really nice varied rocks, really nice varied trees, stuff like that. It looks really cool. Let's get some blue coral. You see even that, you know, it's got some variety in colour. Yeah, there we go. And we need some trees, which I think is just yet more coral. Giant kelp. Is that too big? No, that's awesome. It's pretty freaking big. And some ore weed in there as well. And as you can see, there it goes, 90%. And if we check our little quest meter, you should be able to see, yeah, 1 out of 2 done. So as long as we do the same thing again for our next critter, then they'll be very happy. And it just looks much more interesting, you know, visually. So, what was that? What happened? Was that the quest thing is done? Yeah. Oh no, that's the aquatic donations done. Sweet. Okay, that portal is nearly finished. So let's get that on the go. Might need to put some food. I don't really want people going down here. Actually, we should stop them going down there. Let's delete that. Banned. Right, our expedition has arrived. So, I'll show you how this works. We're going digging through our mystical time portal. I think that is the idea that you're taking. It's like Stargate SG-1, basically. And you can see that everyone's got these different shapes. So if you click this one, you can see it looks like this. And the idea, this is not an efficient way to do it, what I just did, is that you uncover things around the map, like so. If you double click on an area, it breaks it, so you do have to be a little careful. I don't really worry too much about this, if I'm in case you couldn't figure that out. I tend to just sort of assume that I'll get them all anyway. But it can pay to be a little bit more careful than I am. Oh, I double-clicked by accident. Ah! Anyways, got all the items. And we'll go out on another dig. We'll just make it a shallow one, and we're going to go aquatic this time. Actually, before we do that... Oh, we've already got the Plesiosaurus, right? Elasmosaurus? Yeah, cool. You know what? Let's go deep again. Let's go deep. Okay, so... We've got a few things there. We've got some money, which is nice. There's some semi-aquatic skulls. We've got semi-aquatic footprints. We've got some hats. But basically, you can equip your dinosaurs with hats and it'll increase their appeal. You can equip your staff members with hats as well. But you can only do it when your dinosaurs are fully grown. If we find a staff member somewhere, let me... If I was a staff button, I would be down here. Who deserves a hat? Who's my highest level? Dwarf level 2. Who's the quickest? Oh, but yeah, I'm not going to see Bilal. Cromon. Right, Cromon needs a hat because... First of all, because she's an absolute rebel. Look at where she is. But you know what? She needs to intimidate people with her security. That means she needs a hat. She needs an umbrella hat. Hey, there. I mean, you see that coming at you down a dark alleyway. You're going to be terrified. That's what you want from the security guard. Okay, night has arrived. One of the things we can do now is add some lights as well. And the lights aren't just visual. They're very pretty, but they're not just visual. Because if you add lights... it keeps people in your park for longer, which makes sense when you think about it, really. Because they can, you know, see what they're doing. So, just going to dot some lampposts around. It also just makes it so much prettier. And I think we all know what's important to me. It really does look so much nicer. Look at that, absolute beauty. Can you get around there? No, okay. Those are not allowed. These are bad lampposts. I'm sorry, lamppost. I'll always love you. There we go. Doesn't that look really nice? It is beautiful stuff. What is that? It's glowing like a... Oh, it's a human. It's glowing like a terrifying... Alright, where's the default? There it is. Yeah, beautiful stuff. What is going on here? Seriously. Oh, it's the donation bin. Catching in the light. It's kind of beautiful. Isn't that cute? Yeah, this game has such good creativity, and as you unlock more things, you get some crazy lights, and you get some crazy other things, and it's honestly really good stuff. Right, now we got those fossils, but we need more than just that, so we go back to the town. Oh, you know what we need to do? I just remembered. We actually need to feed our Dunkleosteus, which makes a lot of sense. So you see we've got all these feeders here. What we're looking for is an aquatic one called a ring feeder. We'll put that in there. And if we go into town and go into our meat section, you can see that we've got one creature here. So our Dunkleosteus wants fish. So we're going to stock up on a little bit of it. And then you can get a certain amount delivered to you every day. And then we just set our feeder to fish. And we should be good. I also probably need to put a little gate in here, don't I? Yeah. Okay, so what we also need to do, go into town, go to eggs, and you see we want to make an archelon. So we've got the skulls to do it, we've got the footprints to do it, we just need an imperfect gem. So we can go to the gem shop, buy an imperfect gem, and do that. I'm going to grab a pumpkin as well. It's kind of a waste of money, but they're very cool, as you'll see in a minute. But now that we've got that, can we maybe get two of these, actually? No, I need another footprint. But we can create an archelon. Boop! Hatched from the chicken, of course! Where else would it come from? And now we can, you know, start building an archelon habitat. We're a little low on money. You don't get your money throughout the day. You get it, like, all at the end of the day, basically. You get it in a big, chunky block. But okay, it's fine. Did we get anything else? Yeah, there's our pumpkin. I'm going to stick this down. The pumpkin's a very weird item. I mean, it is just a big old pumpkin. I think it was added for, obviously, some Halloween update. And basically, if you tick it, it means, well, first of all, your park stays open later at night by having the pumpkin, which seems like a good thing to me, because surely you'd make more money then. But also, if you tick the scary summons button, it replaces your normal guests with, like, ghosts and zombies and stuff like that. And for people who know me, you'll very much know that that's very much my kind of thing. So we're going to stick with that. And now we're going to build an exhibit for our Archelon, who probably needs about the same space. Where are you? Yeah, 490 for the Archelon. So let's try to build something along here. I need to... I think if you played the game enough, you'd get kind of like an idea for how big an exhibit is. See, that's not big enough. That looks fine to me, but it's miles off. That's going to be tight, but maybe not quite there. What are we looking? 427. Oh boy, we need a big old exhibit. A big old boy. What if I go all the way to there? That's plenty. Blim blamming plenty. Delete this. Delete that. Delete that. So are they in? Yeah, so there is a slight problem with this, however. I don't know if this has always been a thing, but they do T-pose as they walk around, as you can see. so let's hop with the first person for a sec. I don't know why this is blue either. This was doing this before, but I feel like this is like permanently set to be underwater at the moment for some reason. But yeah, it's all a bit weird. It's kind of spooky in a way. Oh god! I didn't know you could do. Oh no! Oh no! And I've okay. That's. I'm gonna turn the pumpkin off now. Because it just looks so... I don't know what this is, what this flappy thing is next to all my zombies. It's very weird stuff. Anyways, let's build a habitat for our Archelon. So what we need is ocean tiles, like so. All the way down there. All the way down there and across there. So that's a beach, which is what we want. But I figure it will look a bit weird if there's no water at all. So if I click this now, as you can see, it's in the beach and we need to keep it at beach, which means we can have some water, but not so much that it goes past this line and the temperature doesn't matter. So if we go into our deep water again, I'm going to put some in, and what you'll see is that beach marker, that red one there, start to move upwards towards the other parts, as you can see. Maybe if I do some shallow water? So I kind of, you know, it's an Archelon, it needs water, right? But I just want to keep it just below the line. There we go, that looks pretty nice. Got like a way to get in and out of the water, and it's got a nice bit to swim around in as need be. Okay, let's pop the egg in, which is in my inventory. Boop. Lovely. And then we've got some basic stuff we need, like an entrance, and set some pathing up there as well. Your guests, you know, for some bizarre reason, your guests actually need to be able to see your creatures. Kids these days, eh? Always using their eyes to look at things. Can't be trusted, honestly. Gone a little far there, haven't I? It's fine, I fixed it. Okay. Cool stuff. I'd probably keep them if they weren't bloody T-posing. I don't know why they are. We should probably get some decoration as well. What about like a pagoda or a mossy arch? How much is that costing? 5,000 bloody. Never mind. Stonehenge? How does Stonehenge only cost $25? Bam! Sorted. Stonehenge is my theme, I've decided. Let's get some rocks. Yo, these are good things for your guests. They like seeing decoration lying around. Okay, Archelon ready? Boop! There he is! Hello, buddy! It's hard to see because of this bloody first-person mode being so weird, but... There he is, there's our little Archelon. Just flopping around in the air. I don't know if he'll go into the water off his own accord. I'm hoping he'll move. Eventually. I'm going to keep an eye on him. We'll see what he does. If not, we'll plop him into the water. Let's grab some donation bins. These are basically the most important item in the entire game. Let's grab some lights. These are also the most important item, but only because they look cool. But is there anything more important than looking cool? Your parents will tell you yes, but your parents are wrong. Okay, and obviously we can... Oh, we need a feeder. Is it plants? Of course it's plants. Let's get a lovely little feeder for our Archelon. Where's the wet feeder? There it is. And we're going to put that into bushes, which I believe is what the Archelon eats. And that means we need to go to town and we need to get a daily bush delivery as well. And I'm going to just grab our Archelon. I can't just pick it up, can I? Right, I'm going to tranquilize it. Actually, tell you what, I'll do it myself. I'm sorry, buddy. Wait, is this a tranquilizer or am I just killing it? I'm actually not sure. No, it's tranquilized. It feels like I'm proper just blasting it. There we go. Yeah, much happier. Way better. Lovely. Don't tranquilize it anymore. Okay, so we can make the exhibit a little bit better. We need some rocks yet again. We need these ones here. What are these for? Oh, there. Oh, gabbro. I want a gabbro. What's a gabbro? I have no idea. So we can get pumice. What's some on the actual beach? Lava. Oh, look at that, bendy. That's, I mean, that is a penis right there. It was very much a penis. Oh boy. I love the variety, you know, that it mixes and matches the shape all the time. Just keeps it really variety. Keeps it really variety, that's what I said. Let's get some bulbous coral. That's pretty sweet looking stuff. Just going until this goes all the way up, like so, and then we need some trees. We need these trees here. Let's get some sea flowers. And some ore weed. Eh? There we go! Nice and happy Wilhelmina. Wilhelmina! That's his good job. So we just need to hatch a dinosaur of tier 2. So we're working on the Elasmosaurus for that. And then this part of the mission is completed. So we've got that. We need to... it's a plesiosaurus, right? So it's just... It's all wet all the time. That's what it's most known for. So let's get some deep water in there. Not going to leave any beach on this one. Oh, wait. We're going to leave a little beach on this one, right? Just in case. There we go. So this should be now a, you see it's photic, but we need a lagoon. That means we need to use another item. It means we need to use a heater. There it is. And we put that in there. And hopefully, there we go. So it becomes a lagoon. You see it even changes the color of the water and stuff like that. And if you're doing this on grassland, it'll change the color of the grass. All those kind of cool details. You can also theme your exhibits now with new items and stuff like that. I don't know how new that is, but it wasn't in when I last played anyway. Right, so. I kind of want like a smaller path for this going along, like so. Gotta do some design work, right? Not too much design work, but a little bit. Do that there, branch across there, maybe have a little something in there. Okay, Plesiosaurus, are you, there you are, boop. Quite excited about the Plesi. I'm excited for all of them to grow as well. These are all young, you've got to remember. They're all kiddiewinks. Even our donkey, which is quite large, I believe is... Oh no, the Dunkleosteus is grown up, which means we can give it a little hat. Let's try the other one out. No, stop. Let's try the Kimmy hat. Darling, you've never looked better. The first person... Oh, see, it works there, briefly. An absolute beauty. I don't know why it's doing this weird blur. There's our... She's ready for a night on the town. It increases her appeal. Look, she's friendly and she's got 80 appeal. Merlin, she. Okay, Merlin's just, you know, mixing up his fashion a little bit. Nothing wrong with that at all. Right, let's grab a fence. Oh, I should use these ones instead. That's too late now. But, you know, there are nicer looking fences, or more appropriate looking fences, shall we say. I'm going to put a little grass in as well, just to make the whole area look a little bit nicer. So just like along there, a little bit of grass. Along there. Might just cover the whole thing in grass, actually. It's kind of like taking the original park and just turning it into something else entirely, you know? It'll give it like an entirely different vibe. It'll look quite cool. Already this feels very different than what we were given at the start. Which I always like. I think it's always a quite a fun thing to do, really. I'm such a nerd. Such a freaking nerd. Yeah, I mean, considering, remember what this looked like when we started, and look at what it looks like now. I think that looks really cool. I think it's a big step in the right direction. How much money? Oh, I've got no money at all. Sweet. All right, donkey, stop. Look how happy you are. Look at this. You don't need to break out. Oh, you do need privacy, though. If you click here, you'll see the privacy boundaries here. So what we can do, actually, to give our creatures some privacy is we've got specific privacy tiles. And these are basically tall... I don't know how this works. What's going on? Does that only work above ground? But let me just try that over here. Oh, whoa, hello. Okay. I guess that doesn't work in the actual water. These below, oh, it is, it's there, isn't it? Oh, it does work. I just couldn't, it just wasn't popping up along the way for some reason. Okay, so basically these privacy tiles will... oh, there we go, there we go. Yeah, it's just, it gives a place for your creatures to hide, you know, avoid prying eyes for a little bit. It makes them feel a little bit more comfortable. It tends to be where they sleep and stuff like that as well. Where's my Arklon at? Arky! There you are. Oh, it's so cute, it's so small. How happy are you? I can't tell, you're inside the coral for now. That's fine. I've got so many science points, we should spend some. So you can get various things, you can get billboards. Let's get a billboard. Get some new lights is what I regret not getting, but anyhow. Nice little tech tree there. So we got a billboard? Where's our billboard? So, where's my billboard? Maybe I need to upgrade it. I've got $4 though, so I'm not sure that's happening anytime soon. Also, my janitor has really been slacking, it must be said. So this. Get here and get it bloody fixed, son. It's a nice looking park, though. Look at it, isn't it beautiful? I don't like this, I'm gonna have to do something about that. If I just replace that with ocean, right? Yeah, that's all I wanted to do. God, take me out of this day, please. I have no money at all. See, it closes at, I think, 9 o'clock. It's my fault, the park's open later than usual. Oh. Oh. Boop. There we go. Right, but oh, there it is. The local town has heard of your excellent work, decided to come visit. Sweet. Got some science for that, our little reward. And we should have some new quests. So what we've got to do is have two exhibits with two dinos at 8% happiness. So two exhibits with two dinosaurs in them. Build three pineapple houses and earn 3 3-star reviews. Oh, earn 10 3-star reviews. So, yeah. Anyway, so that is the new Parkasaurus DLC. Do a little bit more there. I'd like to keep on playing it. Hopefully people enjoy the video. Check it out. You know, blah, blah, blah. Tell your friends. Yada, yada. Share. All that malarkey. Throw me a like. If you enjoyed the video, throw me a like. Throw me a like and comment. Those are the best things you can do. If you ever see a video and you want to see more of that series or more of what's going on, the best thing you can do is throw a like and comment down below. Because YouTube sees that and it's like, yo, people love this video, bro. Bom, bom, bom. That's exactly how it goes. Either way, the DLC comes out in a couple of days. If we come back again, I'd love to carry on with the campaign. At the very least, what we'll do is we'll do another sandbox showcase. I'd like to showcase maybe the Megalodon and the Mosasaurus and stuff like that. So we'll definitely come back and do that regardless. We're definitely doing that this week. But yeah, big fan, really. Build a really pretty little park. Have some cool aquatic creatures. We've got three now. If we came back and did it again, next video, build over here. And we'll do a couple of doubles with some new creatures as well. Don't know what those would be quite yet, but that would be the plan. Oh, what's our place eel called? Also, make this exhibit better, of course, because it's a bit of a disaster right now. That is... Come here. Oscar. Before we go, let's spend a... I'm going to save it now. Spend a little time. Blonk. At least the first person seems to have fixed. There's the heater. Very sci-fi. There's Oscar flying around like a madman. Oscar, what are you doing, buddy? Oscar. I think he's meant to be swimming on the surface, right? Yeah. Oscar is absolutely zooming, slash trying to break out. Oscar, stop it. Oscar! Bad Plesiosaurus. I wish the dino cam zoom. If you're watching this, Wash Bear, this game, I believe, is made by two people, by the way. It's incredible. But the dino cam should zoom in like way closer than this, just as a side note. You know, it'd be nice to be able to zoom right in to take a look at our creatures, because you can't really do that when they're babies. But even the medium ones, well, the fully grown ones, if I dino cam, you know, I just can't get close enough. I'd like to get like twice as close as this, basically. But anyways, we will end it there. Thank you so much for joining me. Go check out the DLC on Steam. I think the game might well, I mean, this is a prediction, but the game might well get a discount at the same time, as it often does with DLCs and stuff like that. Highly recommend it. Really, really cool little park builder. Tons of creativity that you've not really seen quite yet as well. You know, there's lots of items to unlock, as you can see. Tons of decorations to unlock. There's even Steam Workshop capability. There's not too much on there. There's a gigantic bee in my room. Hello. But it's still there. And yeah, thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Houston, if you're ready, we'll go. We'll maneuver.